The Supreme Court has handed President Trump a major victory right now by letting his administration redirect $2.5 billion in money approved by Congress for the Pentagon to help build his promised wall along the southern border with Mexico. It was a conservative majority in favor, 5 against 4, who disagreed with this final decision by the Supreme Court. This represents a pretty important win for the president.
I think it is potentially a significant win for the president. Obviously, it's breaking while we're sitting here on air, so we haven't had time to actually dig into sort of the legal rationale. But this really is a sign that the courts are not going to constrain this president. What we've seen Donald Trump do is seize on provisions, sort of emergency exceptions, provisions of the law that allow the president some authority, and basically flagrantly abusing them, saying, well, you know, I'm saying it's a national security emergency, but, you know, everybody knows that it's not, but I'm going to invoke this provision, and I dare you to stop me. I think that this is the Supreme Court once again showing that despite the fact that Congress has not appropriated funds, this is the first branch of Congress who is saying we have not, we are not paying for this wall, the power of the purse, checks and balances, kind of a big thing. You know, this is the Supreme Court essentially saying, look, you gave the president, you know, a workaround here, and he used it, and we're going to let him do it. Once again, it goes to how important it is for Congress to really stand up and assert its legislative prerogative.
How is all the new impeachment talk playing over there at the White House?
Well, Wolf, tonight the White House is brushing off Democratic leaders' latest suggestion that impeachment is not off the table. I spoke to a senior White House official who told me President Trump is in good spirits today and no longer thinks impeachment is a real possibility. And the president isn't holding back, going after the Democrats, slamming them just moments ago and calling them clowns.
They're doing everything they can with the impeachment nonsense, where you had no obstruction, you had no collusion. You know, obstruction's sort of interesting. They've interviewed 500 people. They've interviewed lawyers. They've interviewed everybody that they wanted to interview, people that had I could have kept back by using presidential privilege. I could have kept back everybody. They didn't have to interview anybody. I gave them total. And then they say obstruction. These people are clowns. The Democrats are clowns. They're being laughed at all over the world. And I watched this morning, I watched Nancy Pelosi trying to get through that with the performance that Robert Mueller put on, where I don't think he ever read the agreement or the document. And the document said no collusion. They don't even talk about that. So there was no crime. They said, well, there was no crime, but he obstructed. How do you obstruct? There's no crime. But actually, it was worse than that, because it was a phony crime that they put on. The crime was what they put on. But I watched Mueller. For 2.5 years, we've watched this. And that's the best they have. And it's a disgrace.
Make sure that, you know, all of our employees are safe. Exactly. We understand that it happens to a lot of people when perhaps you arrive, you're traumatized, and we want to make sure everybody we come in contact with can heal from that.